In this video, I'm going to show you how to create the graphical user interface, the GUI, for our Locations from Web Services tool from Lesson 2. And the GUI consists of two parts, the GUI for the main window of our tool and the GUI for the dialog box that opens up when you click on the Create New Shapefile button. I have Qt Designer running here on the left of the screen. And on the right side, you can see the actual tool that is currently running as a script tool in ArcGIS Pro. And I just used it to add a feature for the Eiffel Tower to some layer in ArcGIS Pro. So that gives us a template for what we're actually trying to create here in Qt Designer. I'm going to start by creating the GUI for the main window. And for that, in the dialog for creating a new form, I pick the template for main window, and then I click on the Create button. And now we have this empty window template here that we can now fill with the different widgets. The first thing I'm going to do is I'm going to change the title of this template, of this form. So that it has the title Locations from Web Services, as we see here on for the actual tool. To do that, I have the main window selected here on the top right of Qt Designers. You see the hierarchy of widgets starting with the main window. And then in the window below it, the property editor, you can see the properties of the widget that's currently selected. And if you scroll down a little bit, there is a property called window title, and I'm clicking on the right side of it now, and then I'm going to enter the title that we want to give it. So locations from web services. And you see that this is directly reflected in the actual form. The title is now changed to locations from web services. We still haven't saved the form, so that would be a good idea to do that now. So in the menu file, I'm selecting the option Save As. I've already set up an empty folder for this project, and I'm going to save this under the name GUI_main.ui. And the name of the file also appears in the title of the window. Then our tool doesn't have a menu bar, but it does have a toolbar at the top with a button for exiting the program, and it has a status bar at the bottom. The status bar is already there in the template, but no toolbar, so I'm doing a right click right in the middle of the form and pick the first option, Add Toolbar, and you see the toolbar showing up there now. Okay. Now, as was explained in the lesson text, the main window of our tool is using a vertical layout to group everything into four main rows, one row for the query part, one row for picking a service to query, one row for displaying the results, and one row for adding the results features to a shapefile, a layer, or a CSV file. So let's create this organization into four rows, where each row is a Qt group box widget. You can find the group box widget in the widget list on the left in Qt Designer under the containers category right here. And I'm now going to drag one group box widget from this containers list over to the form and dropping it just in the empty area in the middle. And you see that we now have added a group box widget to our main window. I'm going to change the title of that group box by double clicking the title and changing it to query term, similar to what you see for the actual tool. Right now, since we haven't specified what layout should be used, this group box just takes up a minimum amount of space, but now I'm going to change the layout of the central area of our main window to a vertical layout. So I'm doing a right click into the empty area in the middle, and at the bottom there's the layout option, and there I'm picking layout vertically. And as a result, the group box is now expanded to fill out the entire area. And we can add additional widgets to this vertical layout, and we want to add the other three group box widgets for the other three rows. So I'm again picking the group box widgets in the list on the left in Qt Designer and dragging it over to the form for our main window and putting it directly below the first group box. And this is indicated by Qt Designer by showing this blue bar there. And then I'm releasing the mouse button, and you can now see we have two group boxes now. And the second one, I'm again double clicking the title. The second one I'm going to call service. And we do the same thing one more time. This time we call the group box results. And a fourth time calling the group box add features. Okay, so we have now created the main organization, and we can now continue to fill or to put additional widgets into these different group boxes.